Do you remember what that was like? Do you remember the anticipation or the excitement or finding something unexpected along the way? Well, I've been on a treasure hunt lately. Jake, I'm going to need my mic here. You know, we had a little water leak at the parsonage. And so that means that I've been going through boxes and boxes and some more boxes and a few more boxes to see what was what. And of course, that's really a statement about me and the fact that I had way too many boxes full of stuff, right? But nevertheless, I've been on a treasure hunt in this basement searching process. And have I ever found some treasures? I just couldn't stand it. I had to bring some of them to show you today. Now, one of the treasures that I found was from when I was in preschool. And it was back in the days when, you know, Easter was even more of a dress-up time than it is now. And so here's what my parents got for me to wear on Easter. A little bitty hat with a little purse to go with it. It's not a parasol, it's a purse. So here's a treasure that's like really old. And then as I was going along, I kept finding some more treasures. And another one that I found, maybe some of you enjoyed this as much as I did, was my favorite game to play. Cootie. You build bugs, for Pete's sake. But I loved it. And here this treasure was in my basement. And then I kept going along and I found something else that I really was excited to see. It's Alvin. Any of you know Alvin, the chipmunk? I got lots of one big tall hand in the back. Well, believe it or not, this was not mine. This was my dad's. Because my dad decided that when we kids, my brother and I, got ready to go to school, it was just way too much fun that we got all the new stuff, right? So when we got our lunchbox to go to school, and they were boxes, metal boxes with thermoses in them, he wanted one too. And so he picked Alvin for his lunchbox. And we enjoyed getting ready for school, and he had as much fun as we did. So treasures abound, and you never know when or where you're going to find something. And I'm guessing that some of you, as you might be preparing your homes for your donations to the garage sale, may find some treasures too. Well, today we have a story about a merchant who was kind of like going on a treasure hunt. He is seeking something that is very important to him. He is looking for something fine, something of great value. And after he does his searching and his seeking, he finds it. He finds a pearl of great value. And then he sells it. And he sells what he had, and he bought this pearl. Well, this story, like many that we've been looking at this month, is about the kingdom of heaven, or the kingdom of God, and it's about a person who is seeking. The person recognizes that there is something that he wants or needs and doesn't really have it at the moment. The person is not satisfied with the status quo, the same old, same old. He's searching for lots of pearls, multiple pearls. Well, like many of Jesus' parables, the pearl is a symbol in the story. And there's lots and lots of interpretations about it. Some read the parable and they hear about this fine pearl, a fabulous item. Not just any kind of jewelry, but a fine pearl, the best of the best, a commodity to purchase. Another idea for the pearl is that it represents knowledge. A pearl can be a special knowledge that we seek. Lots of students who are gathered here and in our community are seeking those kinds of pearls as they begin a new school year. And all of us are often on a journey to learn and seek the pearl of great knowledge. Another pearl that's often thought about with this parable is giving in new ways. The merchant sells all that he has. It doesn't say that he suffered any loss. He has chosen to give in a new way through this new pearl. And there are many who describe this story that the pearl means the most desirable thing anyone could ever have and want. And thus it symbolizes the gospel, the love of Jesus, the kingdom of God. And so the merchant is on a search. He is in search for multiple pearls, and along that way, along that treasure hunt, he finds an unexpected decision within himself to purchase only one. And he recognizes what is of ultimate importance to him. Just as we may recognize what is of ultimate importance to us and to our friends and neighbors. And so this morning I invite you to think about, what is our pearl? My guess is we have lots of them, lots of pearls in our life. Things that come to our mind when we think about those things that we want, or that we are seeking, or that are of the most high value to us. We might agree with those who read the parable and feel like our fine pearl is our focus on our knowledge through education. Our great pearl is to learn and to grow in wisdom and understanding. We seek what is best for our minds. Another pearl may be good health. We engage in nutritious eating and exercise and follow the doctor's orders. And we seek what is best for our bodies. Another pearl may be our relationships, the pearl of our heart, giving our time and attention to the people in our lives. We seek what is best for our emotions and for theirs. Another pearl may be our faith, growing in our learning and believing in the good news for us. We seek what is best for our spirits. For Matthew, the gospel writer, this parable is all about discipleship, seeking to live as followers of Jesus. The kingdom of God is not the pearl, and the merchant is not the pearl. The kingdom is what comes with the words, "It is like." The kingdom of God is like a merchant who is seeking. The kingdom of God is like us when we are seeking. For the merchant, he finds a new treasure. He finds what is of ultimate value to him. It's not just simply the best of the lot. It is what matters to him. And it is something that points him to something new. Well, I believe that we're all seeking in one way or another. Sometimes it's for those tangible things, and sometimes it is for the spirit and for our heart. And whether the object we find is something tangible or something daily or something in our spirit, know that we have the opportunity to receive that gift. Sometimes it challenges us a bit, though. The merchant today challenges us with a question: what do we want? Will we know what we truly want when we see it or experience it? In her book, Short Stories by Jesus, Amy Jill Levine, who is a university and seminary professor of New Testament and Jewish studies, writes about an experience that she had. During the school year, she teaches a divinity course at Riverbend Maximum Security Prison in Tennessee. And the first year that she taught the class, she had 12 inmates and 12 seminary students together in the same class, and they studied the Gospel of Matthew. Some of the students were serving life sentences. Some were candidates for ordination. And so in studying this particular parable, she asked them, "What is your pearl of supreme value? For what would you sell everything? For what would you make a life-changing act?" Well, of course, as we might predict, the seminary students first mentioned the church, but they really did wonder if anyone would really sell everything they had for the sake of the church. And another student who was a member of the graduate department of religion mentioned the doctoral degree. She had this longing to receive her PhD, but it was a challenge for her. Life got in the way. She had a husband who was in a difficult profession. She had children to care for. She was not receiving any support from her family for her to pursue her degree. And yet, there was something within her that just persevered. Seeking more information, she found that the Graduate Department of Religion was there and conveniently located where she lived. And she decided to apply, and not only was she accepted, but she received funding for her education. And so when she entered the program, this is what she said: "I never expected to find myself here. I don't know what will happen at the end of this program, but that does not matter. I am doing what is right for me. I have my pearl." She redefined herself. And in this same class, one of the Riverbend students responded to the question about his pearl, which is simply one word. And for him, his pearl was freedom. He said he would do whatever it takes to increase the chance of his parole. And he realized all of a sudden that the thing he wanted the most was something that he never appreciated until he didn't have it anymore, and that was his freedom. And so he knew that for him it was important to do what he needed to do to break the cycle of crime and incarceration. When he finds his freedom, he will have his pearl. So today, that question comes to us that the teacher asked her students: what is your pearl of supreme value? For what would you sell everything or give everything? For what would you make a life-changing act? You remember that merchant? His search was life-changing. When he receives that pearl of utmost value, he is no longer a merchant. And whether he does what he does is risky or wise, he has gained his value. And in that gaining, he has not only fulfilled a desire he did not know he had, but he also changed his identity. He had been looking for lots of different pearls. that process, he redefines himself. How do we find ourselves in this story? Where are we in this parable? We are invited and perhaps even challenged today to ask ourselves, what do we want? What really do we want? As disciples of Jesus, our life journey is seeking to live like Jesus. Sometimes the most important part is in the seeking. Sometimes what we want changes and grows. And sometimes, in the process, we find a new identity. We redefine ourselves. We learn lots and lots. And in that learning, we demonstrate through our lives our pearls of great value. I can tell you, I'm a lot different than that hat over there, and that game, and the family time with the thermoses, and the seeking to know who we are and what we value is a process that takes all of us together. So as we begin a new school year, a new season in the life of the church, God go with us in the search. Amen.